Do you know what component is the heart of the computer? Well, you'll find out in this video. My name is Tim Bachaka from the Learn Programming Academy, and in this video, you'll learn about the computer's central processing unit, or CPU, along with memory and storage. Some of us geeks think of the CPU as the heart of the computer, like the human heart, brings everything to life, so to speak. Memory, often called RAM for random access memory, is usually used for the temporary holding of software programs and apps and their associated data until the power is turned off. Storage is the term that describes the long-term holding of software programs and apps and their associated data, even if power is turned off on the computer or device. I like to think of memory and storage in an analogous way to my human brain. The difference is that memory represents all the things my brain has forgotten, whereas storage represents everything I can remember and even things such as how to walk and talk. First up, though, is the CPU. Here we go. The circuitry in a computer that controls the manipulation of data is called the central processing unit, or CPU, or often just the processor or even microprocessor due to its small size. The CPU is typically found in today's desktops, laptops and tablets, are small flat squares that plug into the computer's main circuit board called the motherboard. These CPUs are typically 1 or 2 inches or 25 to 50 millimeters in size. The CPUs found in smartphones and other small wearables are about 1/2 that size. Some common companies that produce these CPUs are Intel and AMD. The CPU consists of 3 parts. The arithmetic logic unit, which contains the circuitry that performs operations like addition and subtraction on data, the control unit, which controls the circuitry for coordinating all of the computer's activities, and the register unit, which contains temporary memory for data being manipulated by the arithmetic logic unit. The CPU is an amazing and fascinating device. It's difficult to talk about the CPU without including a discussion about memory and possibly even storage, so I'm combining memory and storage into this one video. A typical CPU cycle includes interaction with memory, sometimes referred to as main memory. So what is memory or main memory? Well, think about the 8 gigabytes of memory, for example, often found in some desktops, laptops or tablets as I talk about this. This type of memory is said to be volatile, meaning that when the power is turned off, the memory loses all the data and software programs and apps that was temporarily stored in it. So this is different than the gigabytes of memory found in your smartphone or wearable, which is used for storage. The storage type of memory is non-volatile, meaning that when the power is turned off, the data and software programs and apps remain held in that type of memory. A few examples of this non-volatile memory used for retaining data, software programs and apps over time are hard disk drives, memory sticks, and solid state drives, also known as SSDs. These devices are designed to hold large amounts or gigabytes or even terabytes of data, software programs and apps. How the CPU works is simple to discuss, but in reality, quite sophisticated. I'll simplify how it works in my discussion here. Follow along with this figure on screen if you think this will help. So let's say we have an app that needs to get its input, 2 numbers, adding those numbers together and outputting the result. Seems pretty simple, add 3 plus 2 resulting in 5. The instructions from the app must already be inside the CPU, and we will not discuss the movement of programming instructions from the actual software program or app into and out of the CPU. The user of the app inputs the 2 numbers, 3 and 2, which are stored in the main memory of the computer. So looking at this table on screen, the sequence for performing this addition operation starts with the CPU's control unit transferring a copy of the data from memory via a bus, which is a collection of wires that join the CPU to the main memory and temporarily stores them into 2 registers, memory inside the CPU. The control unit then activates the circuitry for the arithmetic logic unit to do the addition, which it does, placing the result, a 5, into another register. Then the control unit places a copy of the result back into memory via the bus. The CPU's control unit is perhaps the most sophisticated part of the CPU, as it must do all these steps in perfect sequence and timing. You may have heard of CPU clock speeds, I suspect. Well, the clock speed is what determines the timing in which the control unit does each of its actions. The CPU is simply an amazing piece of technology. It continues to evolve to become even better and faster to keep up with all us consumers demanding that the computer do so much more for us than it used to do just a few years ago. Alright, so that's the end of this section. The next video in this series does a deep dive into the world of software without you being required to swim or be a computer programmer. I think you'll find it very interesting. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in that next video.
Okay, here's where I meant to pump you to click on the subscribe and click on the bell notification. Do that if you want to keep updated with the videos. There's also links on this page, who knows where they are, but you'll find the first video in the series, which might be a good thing to do if you're not watching the first one or the previous video. So click on those links, subscribe, do whatever. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.